It's science education, but not as you know it. On the north coast of Jamaica, the research ship Golden Shadow heads for a rendezvous with some pretty special students.
My name is Kemisha Smith. I'm a second year student attending the College of Agriculture, Science and Education.
There's a big problem right now with coral reefs. They're dying fast.
Kemisha is taking part in a workshop on coral reef ecosystems, hosted by the Khaled bin Sultan Living Oceans Foundation.
We're calling this a coral reef crisis. So none of our grandparents, anybody who's dived on coral reefs over the last couple hundred years, have never seen this happening before. The corals have always been healthy, and now all of a sudden they're starting to die.
One of our missions in the Living Oceans Foundation is education and outreach. We're trying to be different with our educational approach, and we're trying to make sure that it's immersive.
Coral reefs are the only living organism that you can see from space.
As part of the Coral Reef Education Workshop, the students explore the working research vessel Golden Shadow. They find out what it takes to perform detailed science in an underwater coral kingdom.
Science is wonderful. It's not just about lab work or anything, but just going out there and getting the feel of nature.
The foundation also helps teachers get inspired to teach their own students about coral research and conservation. For high school teacher Mike Trimble, being at sea on the ship is quite a change from dry Arizona. He's joined the foundation's CREW program. That stands for Coral Reef Educator on the Water.
I know when I get to the end of the tape, I've gone 30 meters.
Chief Scientist Dr. Andy Bruckner teaches Mike the scientific way to count fish.
We want to know how many are there, but we also need to know how large they are.
Andy, how far off the bottom are you?
Okay, when we're swimming, you're only looking at a 2-meter by 2-meter window, and you're about 1 meter to 2 meters off the bottom. Because you don't want to see what's way up in the water column. You want to see the things that are actually active down on the reef.
Mike's enjoying his first ever sub-aquatic lecture as Andy speaks to him underwater using a special face mask.
You see the green fish with the yellow tail? That's called a stock-like parrotfish.
Yeah, let me show you something.
Direct from the ship, Mike reports about his experience back to his students in the classroom.
This is an underwater full face mask that allows us to communicate underwater.
The most common soft coral in the Caribbean is called the Caribbean sea fan. This animal will eat coral. And in many places, it's much more common than it used to be. Now, this is something you don't want to touch.
That was exceptional. To see these corals, the sponges, the fish, the invertebrates, right there and have expertise giving me complete details.
This stuff is an example of macroalgae. You don't want to see a lot of this on a reef.
From land, at sea, or online, the foundation's education program spreads the message about coral research and conservation.
Exciting the youth of the world and maybe getting them to become a marine scientist or someone who's going to have a true impact on the environment is really important. And so that's one of the facets that we focus on.
The key thing that I learned is that coral reefs are very important and we have people who care about them.